Okay, so yesterday we have been talking about the spiral model, and there we have studied the phases of the spiral model, that is quadrant 1, 2, 3, and 4, four phases. Now we have discussed and we have elaborated what are the different activities associated with each and every phase. So phase one was the objectives, to determine the objectives and identify alternate solutions. Phase two was identify and resolve risks. Phase three is develop next level of the product. And phase four is review and plan for the next phase. So, and one thing also which I have told yesterday, that radius of the spiral at any point, it will represent the cost which is incurred in the project that so far. And the angular dimension, it will represent the progress that has been made in that current particular, that current phase. So, in the spiral model of development, the project manager, he dynamically determines the number of phases as the project progresses. So, the project manager, he will dynamically determine, I will just write this sentence. So in this model, the project manager, he definitely plays a very crucial role for, for according to the specific needs of the project, he will have to identify the number of phases, and this identification and implementation, it goes on continuously till the project is complete. So to make the model more efficient, the different features of the software that can be developed simultaneously through the parallel cycles, those are identified and those are discussed. But here for your course, we are not going to discuss the parallel cycles in this spiral model. But yes, parallel cycles, parallel execution of different activities also exist in this spiral model, but for the BTEC case, we will only emphasize on that the features are developed sequentially or incremental. Okay, so what are the different advantages or disadvantages that are associated with the few spiral model? So every model has a few advantages and disadvantages. So spiral model is also that. So the few disadvantages of the spiral model that will restrict its use to only a few types of projects is that first disadvantage of a spiral model is that to the developers of a project, this spiral model, they usually appears as a complex model to follow. Because since it is a risk driven and is more complicated, the phase structures are more complicated than the other models. So the development team sometimes find it a very difficult or complex model to follow. So unless there is some knowledge and there is some experience in the staff associated with that project, it is difficult to follow the model. So knowledgeable and experienced staff is required in the project, and always it is not possible that a project will always have knowledgeable and experienced staff, because if I always give preference to people having experience, then the freshers, where will they go? The freshers can't break their fresh tag, because without experience, without getting hired in a company, they can't have gained experience. So it is therefore sometimes difficult, because always it will require knowledgeable and experienced candidates in the project, and always for every company to have knowledgeable and experienced candidate for every project is not possible. So this is the main reason, our main disadvantage. Another is, it is not suitable for use in the development of outsourced projects. Okay, so why is that? For any outsourced projects, what happens is the software risks, they need to be continuously assessed. As it is developed, it needs to be continuously assessed. So outsourced projects work on sorry, my connection got disrupted, so the writings got okay, it's not saved. Anyways, so in what happens is, for outsourced project, the software risks, they need to be continuously assessed. And so continuously assessing something which we are outsourcing or exporting to some other people, it is a bit problematic. So these are the two disadvantages of the spiral model. Now, in spite of the disadvantages of this model that we have just talked about, for certain categories of projects, the advantages of the spiral model, it is much more in comparison to the disadvantages of this model. So, for projects having many unknown risks that might show up as the development proceeds, the spiral model would be the most appropriate development model in order to be followed. Okay. Okay. So in this regard, for handling unknown risks that may arise or show up anytime as the development will proceed, so this spiral model, it is much more powerful in comparison to the prototyping model. Because prototyping model can meaningfully, it will be used when all the risks associated with the project are known beforehand. This is the disadvantage of prototyping model. Even if prototyping model also is favorable for handling risks, but the risks need to be told and need to be told and elaborated before the project starts. But sometimes, and most of the real life problems arises that when I start doing something, I start facing some problems. So for those models also, prototyping model won't work. So here, spiral model is the model which will come in hand, right? So spiral model, disadvantage of spiral model is the major what will I say is the major advantage when it comes to spiral model. Okay. Okay, so as compared to the previously all the discussed models, the spiral model, it can be viewed as a meta model since it will compass all the discussed models so far. Because suppose, for example, a single loop spiral, a single loop, it will represent a waterfall model. Spiral model also uses the approach of the prototyping model by first building a prototype in each phase before the actual development starts. Now, these prototypes are used as a risk reduction mechanism, and the spiral model, they will incorporate the systematic stepwise approach of the waterfall model. And also, spiral model can also be considered as supporting the evolutionary model, because the iterations along the spiral, it can be considered as evolutionary levels through which the complete system is built. So this enables the developer to understand and to resolve the risks at each and every iteration or each and every evolutionary level. So why I am saying spiral model as a meta model? Because first, single loop spiral, I will just write this thing down. Single loop spiral resembles the waterfall model. Second, spiral model, it uses the approach of prototype model. How does it use the approach of prototyping model? Because it first build right. So in each phase, the prototype is built before the actual development starts. Right. Now this stepwise waterfall model approach, it is incorporated. The prototyping model approach, it is incorporated. So the waterfall model approach is incorporated. Prototyping model approach is incorporated. Now let us see its resemblance with the evolutionary model. So it is also can be thought of evolutionary model because the iterations along the spiral, okay? So due to its resemblance with each and every model, the basic waterfall model, then came the prototyping model, the evolutionary model. So it more or less is a combination of all these basic waterfall models. So we refer to spiral model as a meta model. Okay. Next is, suppose there is a case study. So suppose there is a company named, suppose this Galaxy Inc. company, they undertook the development of a satellite based communication between the mobile handsets that can be anywhere on the earth. Now, in contrast to the traditional cell phones, by using a satellite based mobile phone, so what was the difference between them? Why was it a project? Because the satellite based mobile phones, the calls can be established as long as both the source and the destination phones are in the coverage areas of some base stations. So the system will function with a few dozen of satellites. So these satellites, they would directly pick up the signal from a handset and they will transfer this signal to the destination handset. So there will be a satellite orbiting around the earth. From the caller set, they will pick up a signal and they will send this signal to the destination handset. So this revolving satellites, it will cover the entire earth. And communication between any two points on the earth, between even between the remote places, it will be possible, right? Earlier, what used to happen? Earlier, it was not that much easy in order to call out of India, right? But now, using your mobile, if your mobile operator will charge something, and if you take the permission, and they will give you that feature in your mobile, for that your just operator needs to be aware of that you want the feature to make international calls, but actually you do not have to change your handset, and also you do not have to change the company which is providing you the network. So this satellite based communication need to be executed in case of traditional cell phones. But however, if you notice, the risks in this project are many. How are the risks? Determining how the calls among the satellites can be handled when they are revolving, the satellites are revolving at a very high speed, and during this, how they will handle the calls, how they will transfer the calls, it is of concern. And in the absence of, suppose, availability of staff with experience in the development of, suppose, in this type of products, many of the risks can be identified if I do not have experienced candidates at the start of the project. And if I do not identify these risks, few risks at least, we are likely to get more risks as the project will progress, because this Galaxy Inc. company, when they wanted to transfer this traditional cell phone communication to the satellite based communication, there was no other satellite based communication at that point of time. So it is not possible that we will have experienced candidate. Nowadays we can have experienced candidate in handling this. But at that time, in that year, we won't be having experienced candidate. So the risks may not be identified earlier before the project has been started. So once the company took up the project and once they have written several lines of code, they have done, then only the project risks more and more became prominent. So for that type of company, for that type of project, definitely we will deploy the spiral model for software development. After hiring the qualified staff, we will have to deploy the spiral model only. And in this spiral model also, in order to develop the independent parts of the software quickly, parallel cycles on the spiral need to be there so that the cost and the delivery, both of them can be met and the project can be progressed and the project can be successful. So it was a case study and it was seen that since this Galaxy Inc. company, they followed the spiral model approach and their cost, their delivery schedule was greatly reduced. Their project was progressed and the project was successfully completed also after only 5 years of the start date. So it was seen that whenever risks cannot be known beforehand, risks will, because in this type of project, the first time they were doing, so they cannot identify what are the risks associated. They will have to start making the project, then only they can identify what are the risks associated. So for this particular type of project, spiral model was the only approach where the project manager will follow this model and will draw the entire picture of this model. Okay, and it was seen that in applying this model, their progress was made earlier, their project was made with lesser cost, and also they were able to successfully complete the project within 5 years only. Okay. So this was all about the spiral model, and with this I have finished the first chapter, that is the module 1 rather. I have finished your module 1, because the first chapter was the introduction part and the second chapter was the different software life cycle models. Okay, so with this your module 1 has been finished. One topic which I just wanted to discuss is, so far we have talked about like what are the different models, in what situations we choose different models, but we need to understand what is the selection criteria or how can we select an appropriate life cycle model for a project. So various life cycle models we have learned, we have studied the advantages, disadvantages, and we need to now understand how to select a particular life cycle model for a specific project. Okay, so first the things we need to put a look on is the characteristics of the software to be developed. First we need to study this, whatever project is hand, what is the characteristics of that project to be developed? Be it an application, be it a product, be it a service, whatever it is. So the choice of the life cycle model, to a large extent, it will depend on the nature of the software that is to be developed. So for small service projects, we have studied that the agile model, it is favored. On the other hand, for product and embedded software development, we have seen that the iterative waterfall model can be preferred. And for object-oriented development projects, we have seen that evolutionary model is suitable. So for small projects, agile model. For product and embedded software development, iterative waterfall model. For object-oriented development projects, evolutionary models. So these are the characteristics of the software which we are developing. We need to study, and after that study, we will understand which model is best suited. Now, next is the characteristics of the development team. Okay, so the skill level of the team members it is also a very important factor in deciding about the life cycle model to use. So if suppose the development team is experienced in developing the similar softwares before, then even an embedded software also can be developed using an iterative waterfall model. But if the development team is entirely new, inexperienced, then even a simple data processing application also may require a prototyping model to be adopted. So depending on the expertise of the development team, if they have expertise in building similar products before, they do not need any prototype. But suppose for making a simple data processing application also, because the development team is not expertised, they are all new, fresh candidates, freshly appointed. So building any basic application also, they will require a prototype model to be adopted. So it also depends on the knowledge of the development team and the skill level of the team members that which life cycle model needs to be used. If the team members do not have good knowledge, always it is better to use a prototyping model so that you can first study that whether they are being able to do or not, and then. And the last is characteristics of the customer. So if the customer is not quite familiar with computers, then the requirements are likely to change frequently, because it would be difficult to form complete consistent requirements without that. So when the customer is not that much experienced and knowledgeable in familiar with the computers, because since we are dealing with software engineering, software products, service, applications, anything. So that case, prototyping model may be very much necessary in order to reduce later on change requests coming from the customer. So later on, if there are any change requests coming from the customer, so customers who are not that much knowledgeable or experienced in handling computers, if we want to develop any software project for them, it is always advisable to use the prototyping model instead. So if the development team is not knowledgeable, use prototyping model. If the customers are not knowledgeable, use prototyping model, because after making the prototype and displaying it to the customer, you can at least understand whether they are comfortable or not with what you are trying to make. Even if your team is that much knowledgeable, but still you need to make them understand whether what you are offering them, they are ready to take or not. Okay, I will just stop the share and open your LMS so that you can give your attendance. Okay, so everyone, mark your attendance. And those who are able to mark your attendance may leave one by one. So this was all about your module one, and with this module, with this today's class, with the last topic, that which module model you should choose in order to select for your project. With this, your module one is ended, and we have covered two chapters: introduction chapter and the software development life cycle chapter. Okay, so in the next class, we will begin with our next module, module 2. And please mark your attendance, and those who are able to mark your attendance, you may leave the class.
हेलो मैम।
हाँ बोलो
मैम, मेरे क्रोम अभी नहीं हो पा रहा है।
ठीक से सुनाई नहीं दिया था, अटेंडेंस में लिख दो। अटेंडेंस नहीं हो पा रहा है क्या
मैम? मैं क्रोम रिस्पॉन्ड नहीं कर पा रहा।
ठीक है, हम मैनुअली दे देंगे। Fine, so that's all for today's class. Thank you.